Hey guys, this is FJ, and first off, I just want to say that I don't want you guys to take the title of this video too seriously. Really, I just wanted to give some of my own tips and my own perspectives on what you should be doing when you're using credit cards. This is more so, I guess, geared towards people who are just getting credit cards for the first time. I know there are a lot of credit card companies that set up tables and booths at, you know, universities or schools and try to promote students to get new credit cards. Usually they'll provide an incentive, some kind of free gift, or maybe give you a little bit of a credit in your account, things like that. This incentive really brings in students. They're like, oh, free stuff. You know, students always like free stuff, so they like to sign up for the new credit card, and then they're told they get about a $500 minimum limit for approval. But what's missing is the education about it. They'll hand out to you a little pamphlet with a lot of information, like fine print on the credit card and what's, you know, it's supposed to happen with a credit card. But really, with students, you have enough stuff to study. A lot of students probably won't even read through that. A credit card is called a credit card for a reason. It's not a cash card. It doesn't mean you're suddenly extra rich just because you're approved. It's a loan. It's a monthly loan. Every time you use it during that month, you have to pay it back at the end of the month. A lot of people are like, oh, I'm against credit cards. Credit cards are bad. It just ends up accumulating debt. But really, it's if you use your credit card responsibly, you can get a lot of benefits out of using a credit card. Let's just say you sign up for a credit card, you get your first incentive, and then you get approved for $500. Some people might see that and they're like, oh wow, I just made new $500 out of nothing, I can go out and spend it. That's not what you should be thinking. Simple definition of it is it's just your limit on how much you can spend in a month. But it doesn't mean that's how much you should be spending every month. My opinion on using a credit card is if you're about to purchase something in a store or about to use your credit card in a restaurant, basically, if you don't already have the money on you or in your account to pay for that meal or for that piece of clothing or anything like that, then you shouldn't be using your credit card. Some people might like to plan ahead. They're like, oh, I'm gonna get paid at the end of the week or at the end of the month, and so I'll have that much money to spend. Don't use it in that manner either. You're setting yourself up for potential problems in the future. You only use your credit card when you know you have the cash to actually spend. So a lot of people might ask, then what's the point of using a credit card? If I could just use cash, I don't have to worry about, you know, carrying extra plastic in my wallet or anything like that. But there are a lot of benefits to using a credit card, especially at a younger age when you're a student. The sooner you start using your credit card, and if you pay it on time, you're building good credit, and you need a good credit rating for your future when you ask for loans for maybe a mortgage or you want to get a loan to buy a car. Things like that in the future, you really need to develop good credit when you're younger. So the way you do that is you pay off your credit card full and on time every month. Okay, so that develops good credit rating. Another reason why it's good to use a credit card too is you don't have to carry as much cash in your wallet. A lot of people feel a little bit safer when they don't carry as much cash. Another benefit is there are reward programs associated with credit cards. So they either give you money back, they give you rewards points under a particular program, and then you accumulate all these points to trade in for, let's say, trips with like miles or for merchandise. These are just some of the benefits of using your credit card, provided that you do pay it off on time at the end of the month. When you get your bill for the first time and you see, you know, maybe you've spent $200 and it gives you a minimum payment is $20. That doesn't mean you just have to pay $20 and then you're free and then you can continue to use the card as you will. No, that's not how it works. Unfortunately, you're gonna be accumulating pretty high interest on the remaining balance. So on $180 left on that credit card, you're gonna be accumulating a lot of interest the longer you don't pay it off. So that's not good. It's bad for your credit rating, it's bad for you, because in the end you're gonna be paying more money. What maybe cost you $200 up front, you're gonna be paying a lot more in the long run if you don't pay it off on time. So what you should be doing is when you get that bill, all you need to look at is everything that you spent within that monthly billing period, and you should make sure that you can pay it off full in the same month. What I like to do is I like to set the payment in my bank, electronic bill payment. It will pay off the bill 2 days before it's even due, just to make sure that the funds go through, I don't get any interest accumulation, any penalties like that. I like to pay it off 2 days in advance, just to make sure. So in summary, guys, again, a credit card doesn't mean extra money in your pocket. You just have a new method of payment when you buy things or when you pay for things. And the benefits of using a credit card is it builds good credit rating the more often you use it and the more often you pay it on time. It's safer too because you don't have to carry as much cash on you all the time. And there's also reward programs that grant you, you know, points, and then you can redeem them for merchandise or trips. Some people might worry, oh, well, if I use credit cards in like in certain places, you know, what if I get frauded? What if, you know, someone gets my credit card? But, you know, with more reputable banks and more reputable credit card companies like Visa, American Express, their protection program's pretty good. If they look through your account and they see odd transactions, they'll most likely contact you and tell you that, you know, there's some weird activities going on in your credit card, so they'll just make sure that it's you still, you know, spending on the credit card. You can cancel it right away if you feel like you've lost a credit card. So there's still a lot of protection and security features on credit cards. So there you go, guys. Hopefully you found that video helpful. If you did like this video, please click the like button and subscribe. Really, guys, this channel is just an opportunity for me to share some of my tips and recommendations, and hopefully you guys find them helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.